Here I am at Pansalimur rocket site, which we discovered on 9th May 1993. After that, I have come here after many years, almost 15 years. This is a tributary of Paroda River. It's a hard manganiferous laterite. It looks like here that this type of ponds were artificially made for trapping and catching, killing fish. This is the end of the platform. I am gone to the end of the platform. I am beginning from the end of the platform. This is recently made an earthen chula type. I'm looking for cupules. This also seems to be some sort of carving. It's not very clear to me. It is a carving of a man. It has not been reported earlier. These look like original stone tools which must have been used for making these carvings. I am on Pansalimur village panchayat of Kolam, Rivana rock art site. People are bathing here and they have disturbed the entire ecology. These are cupules. The exact this one nature, because some of these could be natural due to grinding of the stones, but if there is a pattern, we can definitely discern that pattern. Now there is a footbridge which I am crossing to go to the other side, which is the main part of the rock art platform or gallery. Now these are definitely the cupules. They could be man-made or natural. There is a lot of erosion of the rocks, but basically what happens is this type of stones grind and in the current, and that causes, like here we can see, rotation causes the formation of these cupules. There, when you cross, there is a figure of man, which is a new discovery. Take lots of photographs of that. But you shouldn't fall in the water. There. Means now I am continuously taking. And for you, you can see there is some seaweed like aquaphyte growing at the edge of the stream. That could be a floral sign. Floral sign, floral motif. Now I'm trying to solve. It's like a jigsaw puzzle, you know. It is all a language. All this is a language, pictorial language it is. It is, see, this is a dancing girl, similar to what you find in Mohenjo-daro. Dancing woman. Exactly same position. because this is pre-Harappan, pre-Indus culture. This is pre-bronze culture. You should understand that. It is a pre-bronze culture. So this is one of the most, it is like Lesseaux. Dr. Faldesai, I will explain to you why it is important. This is a bovid. Bovine means cattle, this one. Bovid. And this is a real carving. Means now Dr. Mitragotri and other people call it itching. Itching cannot be going so deep. Have you seen how thick is the groove? See the groove. And it is a Bos indicus, which is extinct. Bos indicus means, this is a gaur. This is not Zibubul. This is a gaur which was hunted, because one gaur can give you 600 kilogram of meat. So they are all hunters here. And similar, you know, contemporaneous rock art forms or paintings you find in Europe, they were also hunting similar animals. So there is a sort of similarity.
That is the head.
Where you see some figure there? No. Further you can see peacock. Come here, I'll show you peacock. Which was discovered later after we left. Here it is. Now, whether they were hunting for peacock or I do not know, means it is very difficult. We have studied extinct animals and animals which are still present in this area. But one thing is clear to me, that some of these animals have been overhunted and become extinct. Understood? So, this is all pictorial way of telling life story. It is a narrative. This is an X-ray drawing. We call it X-ray drawing. X-ray drawing because it is a pregnant animal. There is no particular means, they are slightly means few years apart. They are not done at the same time. And specially they are all scattered. So that makes the whole interpretation extremely difficult. Now these are known standard way of knowing this as cupule. They are found all over world, and Bedrenik, Australian anthropologist, has done detailed study of this. Cup marks they are known as, cup marks. You also find that at Zharmi and Mouse village. Yeah. This is one of the majestic, I would say, one of the beautiful, you see, antelope. Interaction between two animals they have shown here. Animal to animal interaction. And this is a pachyderm or a stylized elephant. Stylized elephant. Man grappling with elephant. But you won't see, you have to get proper perspective to see the man grappling with elephant. And the paws signs are there, paws. And this is a X-ray drawing, carving, which is one of the best in the world, they say. So, rock art researchers say that this is one of the best in the world. No? X-ray carving, X-ray. Potatle dakhayla bitalle. Sikar kele opra. Taja. Dr. Faldesai is there with me and he is examining minutely that X-ray carving. These are astronomical cupules. Mostly these are pleats, pleats cluster. Seven cupules are there. This is elephant ray, stylized. Yeah, that you have to do by orienting the photograph on your computer. Otherwise, it is extremely difficult. Please take individual, pick up individual, because I won't have time to take individual carving, like X-ray carving. Here you see this X-ray carving. There you see one of the most discussed in the world, that one. Then here is pachyderm or elephant. A man is fighting with elephant. Then these are paw marks here. Then you see there is another animal here. Here you see that wild dog. This is a wild dog. तुका दिला मुगो लिस्ट हांवें सगळें बरोवन कशें काडपाचें ती तशें काडपाचें जाल्यार रोबोट हाडया यू कांट स्टडी इन डिटेल यू कॅन डू एवरीथींग See now, this animal figure is zoomorph, is completely filled with water. How beautiful it looks. See, this is a wild rabbit or a dog. Here, this figure. This one. Don't talk. I am recording live video here. See here, there are mating antelopes, male and female. Come here, mating antelopes. Nilgai. This is a nilgai couple, coupling nilgai. I have written about this left and right. Let me move, then you can take proper pictures. This is a rabbit. I have already identified it.
Ani ekta udi marli. Tase nagarpa, todopa. Ekta bitar khandaka padlo, kalyani.
Sujata, take. This is one of the most ancient cruciform figure in world history. This one of the most ancient. You find Indus civilization, Harappa Mohenjo-daro much later. We don't know the. They may be actually plotting the stars. Yes, the cruciforms, they indicate some astronomical significance. This is a wild zebu. Come here. Bos indicus, which was found father, grandfather of all the domesticated bulls. 20,000 years ago, it was existing and hunted. It used to Bos indicus. Common name zebu. It was found right from Afghanistan to Kerala. Now it is extinct from forest. Taka zebu manta, zebu. There are other animals here, you can see. The reason is little further there is a hunting small pond where they used to trap the animals and kill them. This is a magic stock where you can get lot of details in Indus civilization. And here there are lots of other animals they have carved. So it was a hunting camp and fishing camp together. Somewhere close to it. No, it is not bile manis, it is zebu. You stand here. Zebu means wild bull. Taka washinda hate pai. Wild bull it is. Already I have written. See, there are no human figurines here, all anthropomorphs. Understood.
There is one, only that lady is there, no? Dancing.
हे आतां जें हांगा सुजाता तुका हांवें हाडिल्लें ज्या कामा खातीर जाम म्हत्वाचें हाजें म्हाका